Hi everybody. In this video, we're going to be talking about slope and similar triangles. So turn to page 24 in your composition notebook, and at the top right, slope and similar triangles. So I know we have two different formulas for slope, but for this lesson, we're going to use the formula rise over run. So if I'm given the points, x is negative 3, 5, y is 0, 5, z is 0, 3, l is 6, 3, and P is 6, negative 1. I need to plot these points on my graph and find the slope. So, on my graph, I'm going to start with the first point, negative 3, 5. So I'm going to go to the left 3 on my x-axis, which is this axis here. I'm going to go left 3, 1, 2, 3, and then up 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, because the 5 is positive. And I'm going to label that x. Y is 0, so I'm going to stay here at 0, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Z is 0, so I'm going to say 0 again, 3, 3. So label that Y, label that Z. Now I have the points L, so that is 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to the right, because it was positive. Oh. 6, 3, excuse me for putting that point, 1, 2, 3. So here's L. And 6, so I'm going to come back to 6, negative 1. So here's P. So now, I can see that I have a line, or at least three of my points line up together, which are these three here. So I'm going to connect those first. So everyone can see the line that I've created with my points. Now, with my other two points, they don't exactly make a line. But I can use those to find the slope of this line here. By doing that, since I was given the points X, Y, and Z first, I'm going to connect those three together. I've already connected X and Z with my line. Now I'm going to do Z to Y first, because that's my rise. And then I'm going to do Y to X, because that's my run. So if I do Z to Y, and I'm going to try to use a red marker here, so you can see it, and I connect it. And then I'm going to do Y to X. So when I went up from Z to Y, I went start here, I went 1, 2. So I'm gonna put a 2 here for my rise. And then when I went from Y to X, I went over 1, 2, 3. So I'm gonna put a 3 here. Now I'm gonna come back over here and I'm gonna do the same thing. Z is also my starting point. Z was in the middle, so I'm going to connect that with my L and my P. So I have Z, P, and L. It's going to make another. So I'm going to do my rise first, P to L. I'm going to do my run, L to Z. So to get from P to L, I went up 1, 2, 3, 4. And to get from L to Z, I went left 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. First of all, notice that I did go left. So one thing that I did miss is if you go left, remember to put your negatives. So that's negative. And here from Y to X, I also went left, so that has to be a negative. Also notice that when I did my rise over my run, I made two right triangles. You should have two right triangles when you do this. So now, when I'm trying to find my slope, I already have my rise here, so I can do for triangle ZPL, I can put 4 as my rise over, and my run is negative 6. Now, if we reduce that, both of these can be divided by 2. Since the 6 had a negative and the 4 didn't, my answer is going to be negative. And then I have 4 divided by 2 is 2 over 6 divided by 2, which is 3. Now I can check this one over here. I have 2 as my rise over negative 3. Both of those are the same, so this is the slope of my line. Okay, so we found one way to find the slope and make sure that it was even for both of the triangles. Now, there's another way, and probably a better way for us to do it, is to use these same triangles and set up a proportion. So, I'm gonna start with my triangle ZPL. Now, my rise is 4, and my run is -6. And I'm gonna set that equal to my rise, which is 2, over my run, which is -3. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cross multiply to make sure that these are actually equal. And remember, we're big boys and girls, so we don't need any X's or any circles. So, -6 times 2 gives me -12. -3 times 4 gives me -12. So, this way we know that these two triangles are similar and they do share the same slope. Lastly, we want you guys to send myself or Mr. Cohen's this message, this direct message in Edmodo, not to the entire class, just to Mr. Cohen's or myself. This way it shows us that you actually watched the video and you got all the notes. So, good luck, guys.